I was thinking about the engineer, the data scientist who's out there working on algorithms that is impacting people's lives in this way. And I was curious about what advice would you give them as they're struggling with these issues? Because they're realizing, you know, this is not just code. This is actually impacting somebody's life.
Yeah. The first thing that I really, really care about is I think anyone who is working on these systems that are fundamentally making decisions about people's lives is that they need to understand history. Like I, one of the things that I do in my job that surprised me when I went into covering being an AI reporter, I spend a lot more time reading about history and society because like the way that algorithms affect us is fundamentally human issues, societal issues, historical issues. There's this article that I really love. I think in the New Yorker that profiles Mark Zuckerberg after the 2016 election. And there's this quote that says like, he never knew building this platform meant that he would confront like all of the messy questions that make up humanity. Like what is freedom? What is fairness? Like all like that's what we're talking about when we're talking about algorithms that are deciding people.
Yeah.
Deciding things for people at this level. I don't think that the way that we currently educate data scientists and engineers achieves that deep appreciation for being interdisciplinary in that way. And I really think that that's like at a baseline, like just start reading more and like caring more about not just like the technical implementation or like the technical things that you're running up against in your job, but like if you are building an algorithm about a particular, for a particular community or like in a particular domain, just like read way more about that domain, the history of that domain, like problems and challenges that are faced in that domain. If you are building Compass, you should be reading a lot more about like criminal justice and criminal theory and, you know, the history of race relations in America. Like those are all things that you need to be considering when you're building these algorithms. But like day to day, I think when you're working on these things, I think taking initiative at your organization to set up processes to have these discussions. Like if you are managing a team or if you're trying to manage up to the person managing your team, like introduce some way in your day-to-day or week-to-week routine where you're actually sitting down in a room with other people that are working on whatever algorithm you're building and talking through the ethical questions you have. Since covering this area, I've come across like a couple grassroots initiatives. I mean, I'm based at Tech Reviews, like right next to MIT campus. So I'm mostly just observing like grassroots initiatives in academia of how like researchers themselves are grappling with this. But there have been a lot of pop-up reading groups where people will have like a book club, except instead of reading specific books, they'll like debate ethics questions that they face in their day-to-day work. And so like, I would highly recommend that too, if you're not getting the support that you need to think about these problems in your work, finding other outlets to bring together other data scientists or other engineers who are interested in having these conversations and having them outside of work. There's this one reading group at MIT called the AI Ethics Reading Group, where every week they meet and they someone in the group who will be in charge of that session that week will bring a central question that they want to debate with everyone and then put together a reading list of research papers, of books, of articles, of other things that can help inform like the debate. And then people show up if they're like interested in that debate. And it's an organic way for engineers, researchers to grapple with these things that they never thought they, or that they feel ill-equipped to grapple with by themselves. So I think all of those things are ways that you can develop more infrastructure in your life, I guess I should call it, like more infrastructure in your life to support some of these decisions that you're making.
Thank you so much for checking out this clip from the Data Talk podcast. To watch the full episode, you can either go to the Experian blog, the URL is experian.com/datatalk, or you can click on the link, which is found in the description of this video.